Come on, a mission from God. And I took out Matthew 10:1 after touching that hard body of hers with 3 months to live, hadn't been to church, and I laid that Bible on her hard body. And when he had called unto him, if you're not a boy, you've been called unto him. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? Stop playing around. Get serious about this calling. Get serious about God. Get serious about that anointing. Get serious about the power. Get serious. Don't play around with this thing. God didn't abort you when you stay out of church on a Saturday. God didn't abort you when you not to come to church during the week. God didn't save you from abortion to have you just give him a little bit of you. He didn't save you from an abortion not to have a prayer life. God did not save you from an abortion for you not to praise and worship.
That's right, that's right.
And God did not save you for you to come up and lay down your body in a bed of a man that's not your husband. He didn't save you from abortion for this. He didn't save you from abortion to get high and drink liquor, cuss, watch porno. He did not save you from abortion to lie and steal. He did not save you from abortion to hang out at the club and the bars and to be one of them drinking out of that 111 million gallon of beer today on Super Bowl Sunday. He said you could eat the chicken though. You can eat the 3 billion load of chicken though. You can do that. That's fine. But because I wasn't aborted, I went in that room. Now get this. And because I wasn't aborted, thank you Jesus, I turned around and I said to those people who I didn't know, and they didn't know me, I said, she's healed. Hold on. But the doctor said she'd be dead in 3 months. I said she's healed because I wasn't aborted. And I'm speaking what Jesus is speaking to me, because he wasn't a boy. The Jesus in me lives, so therefore I live.
Amen.
The Jesus in me said that I live, so she can live.
Yes.
And others can live.
Yes.
So because I was alive in that hospital room, I spoke life to her. You can't speak like me, mama bought you. There's no praise from the grave. I can't worship you, Father, from my grave. But God said, grave, my grave, where is your sting now? Because you can't get him in there. So I spoke on her, and I turned around, and I said, she's healed, and I got ready to walk out. But one of them stopped me and said, hold on a second, sir. Hold on a second. They said, when you first came in, I was watching you. I don't even know who you were. Oh, I'm watching you. And she said, I spoke to my God. She said, God, if this man, if you use this man to heal my friend, because both of them were preachers at the same church, Great Mount Calvary. She said, if you use this man to heal my friend, I'll dance all over this hospital room. So as I got ready to go, she stopped me. She said, I stopped you because as soon as you said she was healed and turned, I heard the Lord say, you can get up and dance now. Ah! You can get up and dance now. God told her, get up and dance now. She said, God, if this man is used by you to heal her, because he wasn't aborted, he's alive, he spoke life. If you use him, I dance all over. God said, get up and dance. And sure enough, this is on my right. What was it? 1 week later?
Yep, she was on
there. 1 week later, all of them that was in that room walked through this door. She was out of the hospital with no more cancer in her body because I wasn't aborted. I wasn't aborted. I wasn't aborted. God, my God. Come on up in here. God wants to use you. That's why you weren't aborted. God wants to use you, you hear me? You hear me?
Hallelujah.
You hear me?
Amen.
Hold on now. Hold on. Got something for you. Hold on. Hold on. Get this. I said seed, huh? Huh?
Yes.
Go to Deuteronomy 30. Let me show you a seed. Go to Deuteronomy 30, I'm going to show you a seed. I'm going to show you a seed. I'm going to show what he says about the seed. That seed in your body. That seed, that seed. Go to 30 and go to 6. Go to 30 and 6. Go to Deuteronomy now. Say choose life.
Choose life.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Ooh. Say this for me, all y'all here. Say, thank God.
Thank God.
That my mother.
That my mother.
Did abort me.
Did abort me.
Yeah, that's joy right there. Okay, at 30 and 6. I said, Deuteronomy 30 and 6, right? Yeah. Right, you ready? Yeah. And the Lord thy God will circumcise thine heart and the heart of thy seed to love the Lord thy God with all thine heart and with all thy soul that thou mayest what?
Live.
So that seed that's in that belly. Guess what, y'all? A lot of times the mother is going through some psychological issues. Sometimes the mother is going through some mental anguish. Sometimes that young mother or another mother is so depressed that they can't make the proper decision. But they got to know that God is with them. When God said, I'll circumcise your heart, that means he'll purify your heart. He'll sanctify your heart. So we got to ask God to circumcise the hearts of every maiden with a baby in her belly who is planning an abortion, thinking about an abortion, getting pressure to have an abortion. Anyone that's contacted an abortion clinic and want to have an appointment, guess what, y'all? God just said that quick to me. There are some babies getting ready to be murdered in the morning. Do you want to live tomorrow morning?
Yes.
I know you do.
I do.
Thank you. Josh said, I do. I know you do, Josh. With your young self. Listen to me. Hold on. I got something to show you. Just let him have church, okay? Look, Robert, just let him have church. Look. In the abortion clinic in the morning, young ladies are going to walk in there tomorrow morning, go up to the front desk, and sign their name, Jesus. Sign their name. I pray the spirit of Mary will come over them. They're going to sign their name. Some of them are going to come by themselves. Someone come with that no good knucklehead boyfriend who don't even have a job. Someone gonna come with their mama or their aunt or their cousin or guess what? Their homie, their girlfriend. They gonna sign. Now, here's how it works. When they sit down tomorrow morning, the waiting room could get full. And they're all in there. Cause I heard one girl say this, and here's what she said. When it was my turn. Jesus. What? When it was my turn. They just finished 3 abortions already this morning, tomorrow morning. And now it's your turn. Next. Next. That's what they're going to say. Next, bring your baby in so we can kill him. Your baby is next. She said, when it was my turn. You hear me? This is evil. This is demonic. Stay in Deuteronomy and go to 19. Stay in Deuteronomy and go to verse 19 of the same chapter, 30 and 19. Go there for me. Go to 30 and 19. Are you there?
Yes.
I. Who is I?
God,
I call, it's a call, I call heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, I set before you life and death. Go ahead, Shantae. I'm glad you kept your baby. You hear me? Oh, no, Shante, let him go. He ain't bothering me. Let him go, Shante. Tell me his name again. Omar. Let Omar go. Let Omar go. I'm not religious. I'm not religious. Go and preach one day. Now let him get used to the pulpit. Because he's going to hang around. He's going to be preaching for me one day. Now, hold up now. Hold up. Not yet, but you got communion later. Deuteronomy 30:19, are you there?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
He said life and death, blessing and what?
Cursing.
Hold on. Oh, you got a choice to make. We got a choice to make.
Yes.
Life or death, blessing or what?
Cursing.
That's set before us. That's set before us. When a young lady is getting pressured to have an abortion. Young ladies in here, all the women in here, you have different reasons for having your abortion. We had different reasons for aborting. Young and dumb. You hear me? Thank God for redemption. Thank God for forgiveness. If Jesus had been aborted, there would be no forgiving of sins. If you had any connection with an abortion like I did, if you had anything connected to it, guess what? If Jesus had been aborted, you wouldn't be forgiven.
Amen.
But because he was, grace and mercy belongs to us now. Because he wasn't aborted. So hold on. Therefore, choose life. Hold on. It's in the word. When they say pro-life, choose life. It's scriptural. It's in Deuteronomy, the 30th chapter, verse number what? 19. Choose what?
Life.
Choose life. Choose life. Say it.
Choose life.
Jesus. It's in the word. Jesus, Mary chose life. Joseph chose life. Do you hear me? Therefore, choose life. Hold on. Look at this scripture now. Put your eyes on it. Look what it said now. This is from God. This ain't from Angelo. This is not from you. This is from who?
God.
Therefore, choose life that both thou and thy seed may what?
Live.
Ooh, woo. Thou and thy seed may what?
Live.
That thou and thy seed may live. Let me tell you something right now before I close this out. Let me tell you something that you didn't know. And I gave this information out from my research. I gave this information out the other day. See if I have it here. Oh, anyway, let me see if I have it here. I gave some statistics out. Ms. Long, come here for a second. I'm just going to get busy. Answers? Hold that for me because there's something that I need to tell y'all. Hold that for me because I wasn't going to give it and God told me to do it. So take that. God told me to give you this information because you need to know how sick this thing is. I do have a notebook. See, Pastor, you have a notebook? Yeah, I do. See, that when I'm in the spirit realm, I'm just going for it. You hear what I'm saying to you? Now, I'm going to get to it. Hold on, I'm going to get to it. Come on, God. Help me get to it. Oh, I'm there. Hey! Give God praise that I found it.
Amen.
Right, thank you. Ready? Are you ready? Women, I don't preach color in this church. I don't preach black and white and brown and yellow and heaven's best. I don't do that. Because I wasn't a boy. Jesus cares about two types of people. The unsaved and the saved. Not a color. The non-believer or the believer, not a color. Jesus is concerned with the inside of a man, not the outside of a man.
Man, that's right.
Jesus is only concerned with the clean and the unclean. Not the color. But you better hear this. You women in here? In 2014, of all the black people that died in America, every black person died in this country is listed. Okay, how they died. In 2014, 303,844 blacks died in the United States of America. Hear me? Oh, you better hear me now. That same year, 303,844 black people died in 2014. Hold on. That same year, an estimated 954,000, almost a million abortions took place in America. Good God Almighty. 54,000, but it's increased now. Hold on now. Now get this. You ready to hear this? Come on. Come on, I'm going to do the math. Now listen to this now. I'm going to do the math for you. If 36% of the abortions were performed on black women, that means that 343,440 black babies were aborted.
Let me break it down. If you haven't gotten it from the figures, though, let me break it down for you.
In other words, more blacks are killed by abortions each year in the United States than by all other things combined to kill black people, period. Did you hear me? Oh, no, y'all ain't getting it. Hold on. God, how can I do it? Today didn't get it.
Okay.
Cancer. Car crashes. Bullets. Knives. Heart attack. Strokes. Hangings. Fall off bridges. Fall off out of trees. Whatever. Head injuries. Everything that killed a black person in 2014. Everything that killed them. I don't care what it is. You take everything that killed them and add it up. And there were more abortions of black children than all those things combined to kill black people. Do you get it yet?
That means, like I said,
if 303,000 blacks died, but yet you had 343,000 abortions of black children. Ooh, that's demonic. There are demons involved. There are devils involved. There's something wrong with that. Give me 10 minutes. That's demonic. That's satanic. Do you hear me? That's a curse. That's a generational curse. Y'all, if that many black people being aborted, that means that there's a curse in the genealogy of black people murdering us. Stop blaming everybody but Satan. And about making you go get it aborted. You got a free will. There's no law saying we'll put you in jail if you don't abort. Do you hear me? There's nothing. There's no law. Hold on. If you were in China, there is a law. You must abort. In China, there's a limit. You are only allowed to have 2 children, 3 at the most. You try to have more than 3 kids in town, see what happened to your butt. Your butt, and guess what else? They're aborting all the girls.
The men outnumber the women and child like nobody's business. They're born, they got a hatred for the girl seed. Well, guess what? My Bible says that you got to be married and multiply, be fruitful. You can't be fruitful all the women aborted. Jesus. Hold up. Can I tell you something? Let me tell you what Donald Trump just did. President Donald Trump just did. You ready? And he did it on the Sabbath day. He did it on the Sabbath day. 74 lads, look what he did. He signed an official law. He signed with his pen. You better hear what I'm going to tell you now. Because I'm going to give you information that's going to blow your mind next time. Guess what he did? He signed a proclamation. And know what he did? He defunded International Planned Parenthood.
Amen.
He defunded the one overseas, not the one here yet. They're next. But he defunded International, says Louis, International Planned Parenthood. They were getting millions upon millions of dollars to kill all those Chinese babies. But they won't be able to do it anymore because he said you won't get any more American money. America was sending money overseas to have babies over there aborted. We got enough problems aborting babies right here on our own land. Man, we got to help them abort babies in foreign territory too. That's demonic power in existence. Jesus, thank God you weren't aborted by Mary. Do you hear me? Do y'all hear me? All those babies are born like that. Now, get ready. Because I'm going to pray. Look, I'm going to tell y'all something. I'm going to... Oh, hold on. Hold on. Based on the January 2013 estimate, there have been 55.7 million abortions in the U.S. since 1973. Suppose 55 million people still live. 55 million abortions in the U.S. since 1973. Guess what that is? Approximately 17 million of the aborted babies were black. Do y'all hear me? 17 million of the babies aborted, 17 million babies, black babies have been aborted in America since 1973. Do you hear that? And guess what else? Despite an overall black population growth of 12% between 2000 and 2010, the U.S. Census Bureau reports that the black population grew at a slower rate than most other major race and ethnic groups in the country. Did y'all hear that? We're supposed to be the largest ethnic group in America. Now look at us. We're born all the living. Y'all been hearing those statistics? We were number one. We're no longer the number one ethnic group in America now. We're no longer. The Hispanics are number one now. Because we're killing our young. Funkadelic Parliament back in the 70s made an album called America Eats Its Young. I didn't know what it meant then, but I know what it means now. CBS News reported in 2009 that Hispanics have surpassed blacks as the nation's largest minority group. Can there be any question about the role abortion has played in this? None at all. None at all. Here you go, last of the statistics. Oh, you gotta hear this. This is crazy. Anybody know what the CDC is? Huh? It's the Center for Disease Control. They report that during the 1970s, in the 1970s, that's when my abortion occurred, in the 1970s, with my three babies. Two by one woman, one by another one. In the 70s, when I wasn't with a teenager. Young and dumb. In the 1970s, roughly 24%
of all U.S. abortions were performed on black women. That's 1970. Here it is now. Say 24%.
24%.
That's 1970, right? 1980, it rose to 30%. 1990s, it rose to 34%. And in the 2000s, 36%. So we've gone from 24% to 36%. And when you're talking about percentage of millions, you hear me? That means that about 31% of all U.S. abortions since 1973 have been performed on black women. How can that be? How can that be? Something is wrong. Are y'all ready? Are y'all ready? So right now, God.
Right now, God.
I want to thank you.
That
Mary.
Did not abort Jesus.
I want to thank you.
That my mother.
Did not abort me.
I
want to thank you.
That I did not.
Abort my child. The one that's living now.
I thank you.
For forgiving
all abortions
in Christendom.
Everyone that repented,
including me. Now, Father,
release your
angels,
please.
To every woman
that's thinking about an abortion.
That's planning an abortion.
That made an appointment to have an
abortion.
That's being pressured to have an
abortion.
To tell her.
To choose life.
For her.
And her seed. Give God praise up in here. Oh, okay. Now, ushers, get ready. Bless the take the tithes and offering to ushers. And then, before you leave, I want to release healing to your body before you walk out. I want your belly healed for life. I want your colon healed. You hear me? I want all your organs in your body working correctly. Got it. What happened to the lady that they gave 2 months to live? She didn't come in? See what I'm talking about? You texted her yesterday. See what I'm talking about? She got 2 months to live according to the doctor with cancer all over her body. And she didn't come. Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I told her.
Okay. Fine. Yeah, sure did. And she told me she'd be here today. Yeah. I said, you got no other place to go with this cancer. Doctor told you you'd be dead in 2 months. You want to die or you want to live? Bring that thing up in here and you'll live. Amen. Bring it up in here and you'll live. Like the woman that propped this hospital live. And there have been others. You understand me? By the way, show you about an abortion. Woman had her chest aborted and one of her breasts aborted. One of her breasts cut off. I told that woman not to let them cut her breasts off. When I laid the Bible, when I laid Matthew 10:1 on her breast, God told me she was healed. I told her, you're healed. There's no more cancer in your breast. But her mama, her husband, them, told her, do not listen to that pastor. He told her that. She lived in Southern Maryland. So don't listen to him. Her daughter, all but one, who knew us, told her, I've seen miracles in this church, mama. Mama, if pastor, you healed. And her husband said, do not go to that church anymore. Don't listen to them. Get your breast cut off or you're going to die. But guess what? She went and got it cut off under pressure, just like abortions. But guess what happened, y'all? Found out that she didn't have to have that breast cut off. She was healed. There was nothing there. They cut it off. And she didn't have nothing. So guess what she did, y'all? Out of her own mouth. She wouldn't come back. Guess why she said she wouldn't come back? She said she was ashamed. She said, I was ashamed of coming to this church. She said, because you told me I was healed. And I believed that I was healed. But from all that pressure, I went ahead and cut off. And I should have listened to you. And she said, she was so ashamed to face me. I said, you're not going to be ashamed to face me. And got her breast cut off wrongly. Of course they will. They'll believe the doctor first. Now, why are you doing that? I'm going to cut off from Facebook and Periscope, and I'm going to pray for you. In the name of Jesus, today's my birthday again, Periscope. Jesus Christ, Mary did not abort Jesus. Therefore, you live and I live. Therefore, we win because Jesus won. Goodbye, Periscope.